Nor a hungus herp on greuish, egavilis a shay, hug shandalaha o ulskal nirina imel ferishta, skewer der nilan, give his rodish untuntus kurhach shop.
When we actually came out onto site, what we were met with was a big flat slab of stone. We can actually see into the section, we can see through a crack that we could see the burial and the pottery vessel in it as well. So we had a fair idea that it was actually Bronze Age in date. It's a very typical sort of Bronze Age burial, the way they used to do it, especially during the early Bronze Age, around about 2000 to about 1800 BC. So what we do, we just did a normal archaeology thing. We dug down, exposed the whole thing, and then we lifted the lid of the kist, and that's where my job really becomes a privilege, because you know that you're the first person in 4,000 years to see this site. You know the last person to see that person when they went into the ground was probably the family at the funeral. You know, and again, that is a privilege for archaeologists. The skeleton was in the fetal position, so he was crouched up with his knees up to his chest and his arms folded. We kind of think that this might represent rebirth, you know, that it's kind of like the baby would be in the womb, you know, and it's kind of like maybe, you know, this life has ended, so this is the rebirth for the next life.
He would have been between sort of 40 and 60 when he died, so that was a very good age, and he was about 5'11", and he looked like he'd had, from his bones, we could say he had quite an arduous physical existence. You know, he had lots of evidence of arthritis. He had a healed injury in his heel, so he must have, you know, had some sort of an injury or fracture or twist on his ankle at one stage. And he even had sort of evidence in one of his shoulders, again, sort of suggesting very strenuous muscle use.
Tá sé dacar a haolú gur siúil an fear seo talamh in Ilán beag nach ceithre mhíle bliain ó hen. A cadas a dáine sé agus a hinsir ar dúis.